Take decision if you know what you want, and you know what you want if you're clear on your values. Hi guys, this is Shruti, and I'm here to present to you a spirited show which is going to define what value education do to you in your life. This is a passion that calls for that it's not just the academics that gives you education, but the real education is how are you on your values, on your integrity, responsibility, working and dealing with life. So here I present to you our first guest, Mr. Sushant Kalra, who himself is full of spirit, full of energy and enthusiasm to bring change and impact in lives of parents, teachers and children. Hello. So firstly, I would like to thank you for being there in this early morning.
Thanks, Swan. This is beautiful. I always wanted to be in a place like this early mornings. Never done it. So thanks to this, I actually came here. But yes, if you ask me, it's the one of the most beautiful experience of a person. As I said, at some point of time, I never wanted to be a parent.
Oh, really?
Me and my wife, we never wanted to have kids. And that could be one of the genesis of why we started Parvarish. But I think it's the most beautiful experience of my life. It's something I would say nobody in this world should be left out to experience this. So, can't be described. Can't be better.
And there was something that I think it was a calling that made you do Parvarish?
Yeah. As you're asking this question, I'm having goose pimples all over, right? Oh. Just bringing all that back.
I'm sorry for that.
So it's like, so I was in corporates, right? Uh-huh. I'd worked about 18, 20 years in companies like Steel Authority of India, Bank of America, Credit Capital, Max New York Life. As I said, we never wanted to have kids. But when in India, when you get married, it's almost impossible not to have kids.
I can relate to that.
Right. So everybody would want to make sure you have kids.
Yeah.
And the reason why we never wanted to have kids was that we saw parents struggling. We saw every parent struggling. Mm-hmm. From a newborn to a teenager, there were phases like sota nahi hai, khata nahi hai, peeta nahi hai, sunta nahi hai, padhta nahi hai. Aur jab bade ho jate hain to ye to bhaiya aap galat sangat mein pad gaye hain, ye to sunte hi nahi hai. So teenager, the generation gap. So we said, why bring a life into this world where all your life you're cribbing about it? True. And it's not just parents. When we saw children, they're doing the same thing. They're saying, parents peeche pade hue hain yaar, bahut pressure hai, kuch nahi karne dete. To mein kaha yaar, fayda kya hai? That kid also is not enjoying it, we are also not enjoying it. What's the point? And when Aman was like conceived, we said, there has to be a different way. There has to be something different. Everything can't be so wrong. So we researched 24/7. I was like observing kids, observing children, observing parents. Kyun ho raha hai, kaise ho raha hai, read a lot. And what we did with Aman for the first few years was a miracle.
Okay.
And not because we did something different. We said, yaar, ye to bahut simple hai. And every day of parenting was fulfilling, is enjoyable. It's not something which parents say. Yaar. Parents look back and say, yaar, I must have done something good because my son is here. And my daughter is doing so well. But I said, that's not the point. What about my day-to-day experience? If day-to-day experience is like, is exasperating, is tiring, then it's not worth it. Our experience was completely opposite. So, dimag mein ek fitur chad gaya ki yaar, ab to na, this is something which me and Monica do it. And we were finance experts. We were into finance. Working 14, 15 hours a day, spending less than an hour at an average with him. If we can do it, everybody else can do it. So, I said, yaar, agar ye cheez mereko mil gayi hai and I've been able to crack this code, why not spread it? And that experience was so beautiful that my whole thing was, can I give it to everybody I meet? That was the trigger. And I, And then I said to myself, yaar, corporate life, CEOs, ये सब कोई भी कर लेगा यार, ये कर लेंगे, ये पैसे कमा लेंगे, but this which is there, which is so beautiful, why not give it away to people?
The question is that, isn't it contradicting factor that when there were like lot of children in the house in our time, like not my time, my parents' time, there were 8 to 9 siblings and they were easy to handle. Children.
Easier to manage large number of children.
It was easier to manage large number of children. And what do you have to say on that?
Yeah, very pertinent. It brings out a couple of things and one of the bases of Parvarish out of this question itself. So one thing is that at that point of time, parents were more worried about providing the basics to their own children.
Okay.
It's like getting the food on the table, getting a shelter in there. So that was the focus. And because there were large number of children, they had to fend for more.
Yeah.
And the role modeling which happened by parents that time was that they're very passionate about bringing something to the table for the family and the families together. So that role modeling was happening automatically. The other thing which happens here is like, I tell you, parenting does not come naturally,
okay.
Right? It's an art. But what was happening automatically in that period was that because parents were not bothered about what a child is doing all the time,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of time to be.
Right.
The basis of Parvarish, okay, is basically that every child is born no limit.
Yeah.
Right. In Hindi, we call it asimit paida hua hai. So asimit is basically there's certain traits every child is born with. So, for example, his self-esteem, his self-confidence, self-expression, the ability to explore, you know, question, try out new stuff, it's all there, right? So, what happened naturally at that time, because there was less intervention of parents, children got, this whole qualities got nurtured automatically. So, if I'm roaming around in the mud,
mm-hmm.
there's nobody there to say, arey, mitti mein mat ja. पानी में मत खेल ठीक
right.
है मैं भीग के आ गया मैं कीचड़ से खेल के आ गया सो आई एम नेचुरली प्रैक्टिसिंग इट एंड देयर इज नो स्टॉपिंग मी राइट नाउ पेरेंट्स आर ऑन लाइक ऑन टॉप अब वो खा क्या रहा है अब वो खेल क्या रहा है अब वो पढ़ क्या रहा है अब कब पढ़ेगा अब कब खेलेगा उसने ऐसे क्यों बोल दिया यू आर सेइंग राइट मेरा बच्चा रोता बहुत है अरे यार क्राइंग इज फाइन इट्स ओके टू बी सैड इट्स ओके टू क्राई आउट राइट नाउ इफ यू थिंक वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट objective of a parent has become I have to keep my child happy.
Yes.
Right? A child says, Mummy, I'm bored. Yeah.
Well,
mom will do everything to make him feel good. Agar main ye nahi mila to main rone lag jaunga. And he cries. You do everything to make him happy. That's not parenting. It's natural, yeah. It's okay to be sad, it's okay to be bored, it's okay to feel to cry out. Let him cry it out. Let him move out of his pace naturally and develop that tenacity.
Yeah.
Right now, what's happening is parents are saying, "Arey yaro bichara bore na ho jaye." So, main beech mein aa raha hu. So, what is my ability to move out of my boredom and come out of it?
Mm.
That's gone down. So suddenly, I'm out somewhere and I'm sitting in a park. It's a beautiful place. I'm bore ho raha hu. Chal, theek hai beta, ye phone le le.
Right.
So, my ability to move out of that is gone outside, either to my parents, to an instrument, to anywhere else.
Mm.
The minute a giraffe is born,
mm.
like they don't have strength in their legs,
okay.
the mother kicks the giraffe, the baby giraffe,
okay.
and it falls again and tries to get up and is not able to get up. She kicks him again. She keeps kicking him till the time he's able to stand up and run.
Mm.
And that is done right there when they're born. The giraffe is not kicking her newborn because she wants to kick him. She basically wants him to start and run right now because the next minute there could be somebody preying on him. And what humans are doing, actually we're trying to protect them.
Yeah. And protect to extend that a 4-year-old boy, I mean, he is asked like which school I should put him so that he'll go enters the IITs in future. So it's like you're so well defining and designing his life, which even he is not exposed to.
Exactly.
So I think this is what is killing kind of the people we have.
Yep.
There is one more thing that I think you will be facing a lot about learning disabilities. So I think this is a very interesting topic.
Exactly.
When I was in college, I discovered that I was ADHD.
Wow.
And I thought, okay, just because I was really restless and I wanted to touch everything, I was kinesthetic, I was visual and lots more. I said, oh, really? I mean, throughout the process, I just thought I was a student.
Yeah. Believe me, it doesn't exist at all. It's like, as I said, because you're looking at children like this, they're always on top of them. They move this bit. Yaar, ye na thoda sa alteration ho gaya. And you look at it like an alteration. And in our times, this was not an alteration. Yaar. Bacche bhagte hain. Bacche girte hain. Bacche masti karte hain. Bacche ek jagah pe nahi baithte hain. And it was normal, right? Right now, you're measuring them so closely that even a small shift is look like an aberration. So you're measured every minute. You're in a class of 40. 10 children who are not performing up to a certain level are termed learning disabled or learning difficulty children.
Yeah.
What is actually happening with these kids is that every child is learning differently. Now, you said you're a kinesthetic learner,
yeah.
Okay. So if I make you sit in a class which the teacher says, sit down on your chair and you're not going to move, and she keeps talking to you, after 10 minutes, you will start fiddling around. You will start troubling the person next to you. You will start throwing your eraser or a pencil, or you start banging the table. You're looking out of the window. Because what she's saying is just not going into your head. And you need to move. And she's saying, don't move. After a while, you'll be somebody who's saying, ma'am, you're disturbed kar rahi hai. Okay, she's the disturbing kid. What do you do with the disturbing kid? Ask her to go out of the class. Or these days, they're the great things, okay? So you have a special educator or you have a counselor. You say, yaar, ye na class mein handle nahi ho pa rahi hai. इसको स्पेशल एजुकेटर के पास लेके जाते हैं या इसको काउंसलर के पास लेके जाते हैं. सो व्हाट यू हैव डन, हियर इज अ किड, शी इज नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन दिस बिट, यू पुटिंग हर आउट ऑफ द क्लास, यू हैव रिड्यूस द एक्सपोजर, यू से यार इसको ना इतने लेवल पे समझ में नहीं आता, इसका कोर्स भी कम कर दो. तो पहले ही मुझको समझने में थोड़ा देर लग रही है एंड आई नीड समथिंग एल्स टू अंडरस्टैंड. यू हैव रिड्यूस माई एक्सपोजर. A child who takes 10 hours to learn how to bicycle, another child takes 10 days. If I don't expose that child to 10 days of cycling, he will never learn cycling. So what you've done, rather than making the exposure higher because I'm taking more time to learn, you're actually reducing the exposure.
Yeah.
So if I reduce the exposure, I need 20, you've given me 5. So my gap increases. And if I measure you after 2 years of increasing this gap or increasing this exposure, you will be definitely at a level. So at class 5, you're measured and you say, "Arey yaar, ye to second class ka saman janti nahi abhi tak." So you are slow learner, you are learning disabled, or isse match nahi ho raha hai. Abhi to hum quadratic equations kar rahe hain, to abhi tak addition subtraction kar rahi hai.
And you become special.
And you are dyscalculia. Isko agar hum denge, to ye bichari ab 10th mein to fail ho jayegi.
So don't give.
To wo wala hatai do. To maths hata do so that she scores well. If she scores well, she'll get an admission somewhere.
And the whole life, the children think that I can't do maths.
You can't do maths?
And then after Tare Zameen Par movie released, every house had one dyslexic child of 2 years to 4 years. Are ye to ulta bhi likh raha hai, you know, it's a dyslexic. I don't understand. I mean, if anybody starts writing, we'll start. That's a process of writing.
Yeah.
That's not dyslexia.
I think people got the other way around.
Okay.
That movie beautifully brought up that it's perfectly fine to be the way they are.
Yes.
And this is the route you chose. This is the route somebody else is choosing. And everybody chooses their own way to reach somewhere.
Yeah.
Right? This kid who was supposedly dyslexic and learning disabled because he couldn't read, he couldn't write, he couldn't do math, he couldn't do science, he couldn't even do Hindi, right? He was not able to write properly.
Yes.
And this guy was brilliant at art. Now, if I tell you, you cannot paint without mathematics.
Okay.
You cannot paint without mathematics.
So all the artists right there, you need to know this. If you know mathematics,
you can't paint without physics. You can't paint without chemistry. You can't paint, right? Because if you really look at any picture, you will only see shapes. And there is a proportion of shapes. If I make something like this, like a pinpoint one, versus a this, which was more to look like a mountain? This or this? One which is like this. So if I don't get the proportions right, my painting will not be natural. Now if you really look at it, okay, I'll tell you something which would be baffling.
Okay.
This divided by this.
Okay.
So your height of this time divided by this time is 1.6.
It's 1.6.
approximately.
Okay.
And if you make a face with this proportion as 1.6, it'll look like a human face. You just make a circle like that and people will call it a human face. Let's do a small exercise, okay? Take your finger, put it from your forehead and put it till here.
Okay.
Just put it there.
Okay.
It'll come till here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now put it again, put it from here till the end of your nose.
Yeah, it's here.
And put it from here till the end of your chin.
Yeah.
What did you notice?
It's still here.
It's still here.
Yeah.
One third, one third, one third. Anybody in the world can do that. Your face has proportions. That's mathematics. Okay. You measure a height.
Okay.
Like the entire height.
Okay.
And then measure your height till your navel.
Okay.
Okay. If you divide your entire height and your height till your navel, it'll be 1.6. Right. Yeah. So it won't be exactly 1.6. So rounded off to one digit, it'll be 1.6. Across the board, any human being, try it out.
So this is not the end, guys. We are going to come up with a lot of spirited people and their stories. Watch this space for more videos and more episodes. Here is the email ID. You can just write to us your views, your thoughts. And if you wish to be featured, you can even have a quick chat with us. So stay spirited. Namaste.